Hey everyone, here's another video about this mystery HP Chromebook 11 2001 TU. And for those of you who are wondering why I'm making these videos, it's because I appear to have bought an unannounced HP Chromebook that no one else has any information about. So this is a scoop, so to speak. Anyway, the story so far is basically I bought this HP Chromebook 11. It looks like a miniature Chromebook 14. It does not look like the currently sold model of the HP Chromebook 11 in the glossy plastic. And I got a number of questions on Reddit about this computer, and I just wanted to answer some of them, bringing up the Chrome forward double slash system information. I can confirm a couple of things for you. Just one thing, if you can see that here, the Chrome OS version is 34.0.1847.134, and I think that's just auto updated to the latest version because I have been playing around with it. The actual CPU, in the CPU information dialog, and I'll bring that up, it is, and I can confirm this, it is a Samsung Exynos 5 processor. It is not one of the new Intel Celeron processors. So again, I'm quite confused as to what this computer is, because it feels like it's a bit late for them to be releasing a new revision of this computer still using the Samsung Exynos 5 processor. And as I've played around with the Acer C720 and the Toshiba, which both have the new Intel processors, they are definitely snappier in scrolling performance and that kind of thing than this computer. So it feels like that HP was shooting for a budget revision of this of the HP Chromebook 11, because in most respects this appears to be a inferior spec. Just about the actual battery life of the computer, I haven't timed it from a full charge, but the computer seems to predict a battery life of anywhere between 4 and 6 hours off the full charge. I've just been playing around with it and that's kind of what I've gotten. It does, like the normal HP Chromebook 11, it does charge by micro USB, which is kind of why I bought this computer compared to the Toshiba or the Acer C720, just because I sometimes forget my charger and that makes it kind of convenient. In terms of the display, as you can see here, this is most probably not a TN, I'm sorry, not an IPS panel. It is most definitely a TN panel because the viewing angles are pretty terrible. You can see that kind of contrast shift immediately. The screen does go up really bright and it is of the, I think, 1366 by 768 resolution. It has a matte finish instead of a glossy finish, so it is somewhat anti-reflective. I haven't really taken it outside yet, but it is definitely not a nice IPS panel like the HP Chromebook 11, the 1101, which again makes me think that this is a budget revision. So in comparison, here's my Surface Pro, which has an IPS display, and you can see the viewing angles are much, much better. Overall, in terms of build quality, it does look like a miniature HP Chromebook 14. It does feel quite solid. It does have a nice build. In particular, I think the trackpad is really nice. It's really smooth. It's probably the best trackpad compared to when I was playing around with the Acer C720 and the Toshiba in the shop. So it's kind of really smooth. It's not gummy in any way. Really nice trackpad. The keyboard is also really nice. It's not as clicky as the Acer C720 keyboard. It has a bit more of a spongy feel to it, but overall it's well spaced. It has a decent amount of travel. It's just a little bit gummy, but it's on par with the Toshiba and the Acer keyboard. I don't know if it's as good as the HP Chromebook 11, like the normal version, because I haven't tried it, but I haven't tried it side to side. I only played around with the dummy models before. I'm getting a bit distracted, but I did, on this particular typing test, which is 10fastfingers.com, I did get up to 100 words per minute on this test before. So it's certainly a good keyboard for typing, which is why I also bought this computer. Let's just give up on that for now, because I'm probably getting a terrible score. Between point, these keyboard typing tests are quite odd. Anyway, So I got 83 words per minute that time, but I have been able to get to 100 words per minute when I'm not being distracted by talking to you guys. In terms of the web camera, I had originally thought that this computer had a dual array microphone, because if you look here at the top, it has two little dots. And I thought these might be both microphones, but it turns out one of them just lights up when you turn on the camera, sorry. So I don't know if that's just an LED or if it is in fact a second microphone with an LED next to it. The actual webcam quality itself is pretty terrible, just because it looks like someone has smeared some soap across the lens or something. It's not the best web camera in the world. It's a bit murky, but whatever. Overall, in terms of build, it's a really nice computer. It has this kind of matte powder finish on the white at the top. The bottom is this dimpled white plastic. Overall, it's a lot more grippy. It feels better than the kind of glossy plastic used in the normal HP Chromebook 11, but it does feel... I don't think this is the 1.04 kilogram weight of the HP Chromebook 11. It seems more like that this is slightly heavier. It's not that dissimilar in weight to my Surface Pro 2, which including the keyboard is about 1.1, 1.2 kilograms. So I think that weight specification listed on that webpage from HP is the correct one. Sorry, there's some bird going crazy there. But yeah, I think this is meant to be a budget version of the HP Chromebook 11, as if you kind of needed that. I'm not sure. I don't even know if this will be sold outside Australia. But anyway, if you have any questions about this computer, I'm not that familiar with Chrome OS. This is my first Chromebook. So if you have any questions, just leave a comment and I will try and see if I can get you the answers about this computer, seeing that I appear to be the only person in the world with one of these, at least on YouTube anyway. Yeah, thanks to all my regular subscribers. This is kind of exciting because it does appear to be an unreleased product. You can talk to me on Facebook at facebook.com/lockandlikesathing or on Twitter at @locklikesathing. I've also started a Reddit thread on this computer in the Chrome OS subreddit. So you can join in that discussion. I've linked it in the description of this video so you can check that out. But anyway, have a good one.